నమస్కారం. కళాక్షేత్రం కార్యక్రమానికి స్వాగతం. వారం వారం వైవిధ్యమైన కళాకారులతో సాగిపోతున్న మన ఈ కళాక్షేత్రంలో ఈరోజు క్వీన్స్ ఆఫ్ వయలిన్, వయలిన్ ఎల్లన్ సిస్టర్స్ అనబడే లలిత గారు, నందిని గారు మనతో పాటు ఉన్నారు. వీరు చెన్నై వాస్తవ్యులు. చెన్నై వాస్తవ్యులు అంటే కేవలం చెన్నైకి మాత్రమే వీరి పేరు పరిమితం కాలేదు, ప్రపంచవ్యాప్తంగా కూడా ఎన్నో పెర్ఫార్మెన్సెస్ ఇచ్చి ఎంతో పేరు ప్రఖ్యాతలు సంపాదించుకున్నారు. ఒకనొక సందర్భంలో బ్రిటిష్ పార్లమెంట్లో కూడా వీరు పర్ఫామ్ చేసి ఎంతో పేరు ప్రఖ్యాతలు సంపాదించుకున్నారు. సంగీత ప్రపంచంలో వీరు తమదైన ముద్ర వేస్తూ ముందుకు సాగుతూ ఉన్నారు. ఈరోజు మనతో పాటు మన కళాక్షేత్రంలో ఉన్నారు. నమస్కారం లలిత గారు అండ్ నందిని గారు. చాలా సంతోషంగా ఉంది మీరు భారత్ టుడేకి రావడం, కళాక్షేత్రం కార్యక్రమానికి రావడం. వి ఆర్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ టు సీ యూ హియర్. యాక్చువల్లీ మీరు ప్రపంచవ్యాప్తంగా కూడా ఎంతో పేరు ప్రఖ్యాతలు సంపాదించుకుంటూ ఉన్నారు అండ్ క్వీన్స్ ఆఫ్ వయలిన్ అంటూ ఉన్నారు. సో ఆ పేరు ఎలా వచ్చింది మీకు?
యాక్చువల్లీ నందిని అండ్ మై సెల్ఫ్ వి నాట్ ఓన్లీ సింగ్ బట్ వీ ఆల్సో ప్లే ద వయలిన్ అండ్ వీ ప్లే నాట్ ఓన్లీ ద కర్ణాటిక్ స్టైల్, వీ ఆల్సో ప్లే ద వెస్టర్న్ క్లాసికల్ మ్యూజిక్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ఫ్యూజన్. సో వన్ పర్టిక్యులర్ కాన్సర్ట్ వీ ప్లేడ్ ఆల్ కర్ణాటిక్, దెన్ వెస్టర్న్ క్లాసికల్ అండ్ ఫ్యూజన్. ఐ థింక్ ద కాన్సర్ట్ వాస్ హెల్డ్ ఇన్ మొరిషియస్ అండ్ హియరింగ్ అవర్ కాన్సర్ట్ ఐ థింక్ ద పబ్లిక్ అండ్ ద రిపోర్టర్స్ వేర్ ఆస్టక్ విత్ ఆ పర్ఫార్మెన్స్ దట్ ద నెక్స్ట్ డే ద రివ్యూ కేమ్ దట్ Queens of Violin, they enthralled the audiences. That's how we've been referred to as that.
So how did you feel Queens of Violin anagane, what was your response actually?
In fact, I would say it's a humbling experience because when you're fondly addressed by the public as well as by the press as well, by connoisseurs as well as laymen alike as the Queens of Violin, it means that you have more responsibility, they expect more from you, you have to deliver more. So you have to inspire more, you have to do more. So I think in that sense, both of us, though we were very happy that our work has been acknowledged and applauded by connoisseurs and laymen, we also feel that it's a huge responsibility that we have to take music further.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And initially, do we go with any varnam?
Oh, yes. Okay. Yeah. Yes. Okay.
చాలా బాగుంది. అంటే డిఫరెంట్ గ్రేడ్స్ ఆఫ్ టెంపో అని అన్నారు, సో అంటే ఏమిటన్నట్టు?
యూజువలీ యాజ్ ఐ సెడ్ ఎర్లియర్ దట్ వర్ణమ్స్ నార్మలీ దే విల్ బి రెండర్డ్ ఇన్ జస్ట్ వన్ స్పీడ్ ఆర్ టూ స్పీడ్స్ ఇన్ టెక్నికలీ ఇన్ కర్ణాటిక్ మ్యూజిక్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ ఆల్వేస్ ది ఓపెనింగ్ ఆఫ్ అ కాన్సర్ట్. సమ్టైమ్స్ ఐ మీన్ ఇట్స్ ఆల్సో లైక్ It's not compulsory that we have to start with the varnam, but we can also, we can start with the varnam. If we play the varnam, then it's always the first item in a concert. And the varnams, as I told you, that they will be played only in first speed and the second speed, normally only two speeds. But in our family and the violin school of playing that we come from, we have specialized in rendering these varnams in different degrees of speeds. That's what we played now was three speeds that we played. So we can play in three speeds, four speeds and five speeds. So it's
a research oriented specialization.
It's very technical and it's complex as well, because you're changing different tempos. So the number of pulses in every beat is changed. So it's quite a complex thing to handle. It requires a lot of mastery over not only rhythm but also over the instrument.
అండ్ ఫ్యామిలీ లైఫ్ గురించి చెప్పండి, అంటే తరతరాలుగా కూడా సంగీత ప్రపంచం నుంచే వస్తుంది, అండ్ మీ ఫ్యామిలీ అంటే ఆన్సెస్టర్స్ అందరూ కూడా మ్యూజిక్లోనే ఉన్నారు, సో వారి గురించి కూడా చెప్పండి.
వీ యాక్చువల్లీ కమ్ ఫ్రమ్ అ ఫ్యామిలీ ఆఫ్ మ్యూజిషియన్స్ అండ్ లలిత అండ్ మై సెల్ఫ్ వీఆర్ ది ఫోర్త్ జనరేషన్ మ్యూజిషియన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ అవర్ ఫ్యామిలీ. సో వీ యాక్చువల్లీ స్టార్టెడ్ లెర్నింగ్, our first guru was our grandfather, Shri V. Lakshmi Narayan Iyer, and also we learned from our mother, Srimati Subbalakshmi Muthuswami. So we started learning from both grandfather and mother, and we also were very happy that we were able to learn from our first uncle, Shri L. Vaidyanathan, who was a great violin maestro himself, and was also versatile in several genres of music, not only Carnatic but also Western classical music conducting. He was also a reputed music, film music director. So we had such great gurus, and Lalita and myself, we are also fortunate to have learned from the Sanketa Pitamaha, Chamanguri Srinivasa Iyer, for several years. We learned vocal music also from him. So coming from a family of music and musicians, we were exposed to music from our childhood itself. And we started formal lessons in music by the age of 3.
ఓకే, అంటే 3 సంవత్సరాల వయసులో మీరు మ్యూజిక్ స్టార్ట్ చేశారు, అంటే వాయిలిన్ వోకల్ అండి?
Vocal we started when we were 2.5 years old, because when the whole house used to reverberate with music. So my grandfather playing and my mother singing, or her siblings performing, so the whole house used to reverberate with music. So we used to hum, and then our grandfather, seeing that we had interest, he started teaching us at the age of 2.5 to sing, and then we start to play the violin at the age of 3. So there was a small sized violin from
Dayananda Saraswati Swamiji composition ma kosam play chestara.
Yeah.
సచ్ ఎ గ్రేట్ కంపోజిషన్ యాక్చువల్లీ. సో ఈ కంపోజిషన్ గురించి కొంచెం డీటెయిల్స్ ఇవ్వగలరా?
This particular composition, we are devotees of Dayananda Saraswati Swamiji as well.
Okay.
And it was he who named us LN sisters.
Okay.
So we were initially known as Lalita Nandini. Mm. And we had a wonderful opportunity of performing for Swamiji, a very exclusive concert for Dayananda Swamiji in Coimbatore.
Okay.
So when we performed, he asked us how we were called by the public. We said Lalita Nandini. He said, no, you should have a special name.
Yeah.
And he took the first letter out of Lalita
LN sisters
letter out of, and also the first letter out of our guru's name, Lakshmi Narayana.
Okay.
So Swamiji felt that that should be the apt name, and he named us as LN sisters. And I think that's was also a turning point in our career.
And there we performed this particular song in front of Swamiji. Swamiji has composed lot of compositions, this Bo Shambho, then Vandeham Sharada, many compositions. So this particular one is very popular as well. So we performed in front of Swamiji, and he was so happy that he started singing along with us.
Yeah.
So it's such an unforgettable memory etched in our minds.
Okay. And ప్రపంచవ్యాప్తంగా కూడా ఎన్నో దేశాలు తిరిగారు, ఎన్నో పర్ఫార్మెన్సెస్ ఇచ్చారు. అండ్ ఎటువంటి మెసేజ్ ఇచ్చారు ప్రపంచానికి, అంటే సంగీతం ఏం చెప్తోంది, ముఖ్యంగా ఇండియన్ మ్యూజిక్?
Lalita and myself, we've been like really fortunate to take South Indian classical music to different countries across the globe, and to perform for
you have a list of countries actually.
So it's we have also been performing not only around India in several places, but also across the four corners of the globe, taking the rich traditions of Carnatic music to audiences, non-Indian audiences. So one thing is that it's always a pleasure when you perform for audiences in South India who know your music, but it's a different kind of happiness when you take your music to uncharted boundaries, you know, where people know or know very little about what Carnatic music is. So when we take when we become ambassadors of Carnatic music, we become the torchbearers of Carnatic music, of a great tradition. So we take it across to people who are happy and who realize the greatness of this system,
Indian music, and we tell them how spiritual it is, the Carnatic music, the classical tradition of South India. So every time we perform, we also explain to them about the richness of the South Indian classical music and what is so special, the ragas, the compositions, the talam and other aspects, and also the spiritual element is very, very important in Carnatic music as
well. Ala milestones unnai, enno achievements unnai, ento sadhinchukuntu munduku velthunnaru. So etuvanti milestones unnai?
Actually, yes sir, every time we perform there's something happening. I think it's all God's grace.
Okay.
the many unforgettable concerts, like the one that we performed in South Africa, it was in Free State province in Bloemfontein. I think till 90s or late 80s, even the Asians were not allowed inside the particular Free State province, and our concert was a milestone. We became the first Indian musicians, in fact, to go to that Free State province and perform South Indian classical music, and we also did fusion, of course.
Okay.
But mainly it was Carnatic music for which we went, and that was one unforgettable milestone concert. Then we also performed in the British Parliament, which again was one of
I think it's a memorable event.
Yes, actually. And we were also the first South Indian musicians to perform in the British Parliament. So it was an event to honor Shri Kamlesh Sharma, and from the UN, and it was a very huge occasion, and as representatives of great tradition Carnatic music, we were happy to have been invited to perform there.
Evaravarto performance chesaru? So prapanchavyaptanga kuda performances icharu. So ee artistlu toti perform chesaru, evari collaboration toti perform chesaru?
We have performed both as a violin duet.
Okay.
But we have also given some specialized concerts, like we do jugalbandis also, where we collaborate artist which we collaborate with.
Okay.
And we also perform fusion. Fusion is where,
okay, is it restricted to only Indian performers or worldwide performers?
Worldwide.
Okay.
Worldwide.
Hmm.
So we perform fusion, where we perform elements from different music traditions. Lalita and myself, we have trained in not only Carnatic music, but also Western classic and also world music. Like I had the opportunity of studying world music in London while she studied it in US in Pittsburgh.
Yeah, actually, both of us were awarded two prestigious fellowships and we were selected as cultural ambassadors to the US and UK. I was awarded the Fulbright fellowships in performing arts from the US government, and she the Quitt fellowships from the UK government. And where we specialized the world music as well.
So when we kind of have studied and have a familiarity with different musical genres, it was my father's suggestion, Mr. Muthuswamy, who said that, you know, different systems, why don't you bring them all together in one platform? So audience, in the audience, one of them may know Carnatic music, someone else may know just jazz or just Western music. It'll be an opportunity for them to understand and enjoy what they know and also learn about something which they do not know. So we created this idiom called global fusion,
trans global fusion,
where we perform different genres of music, where we also compose the music by ourselves, and we have different musicians also collaborating with us, representing different genres of music.
Okay, how was the experience?
That's making
then?
It a mini global village. That was what our idea was, to make it a musical global village.
Okay.
Yeah, the response was amazing. In fact, our albums were in the top 10 rating when it was released, The Revelations I'm Thinking of You. And we have been doing a lot of fusion all over India and even in the world. Recently, last year, we were in Germany, and we collaborated with the percussion orchestra. Usually, orchestra, it's normally the stringed instruments and a combination of also the drums that comes. But this was only an percussion
orchestra, which is made up entirely of percussion instruments, made of different materials like wood or metal, different kinds
that
of
worldwide instruments.
Yes. So this was in they performed a composition of the Greek composer Xenakis, and we used Carnatic music to fuse with this particular composition and created a special concert. So this was an unforgettable concert, and also we collaborated with free jazz improvisation ensemble in Wuppertal in Germany again, where the musicians played a free jazz, and because it has a lot of improvisation, we used Carnatic improvisations also along with that to create a different concert.
So chala experiments and chala combinations anni unnai
dentro.
Sangeetamlo meer chestunna krushi ki and mee performances ki awards rewards anevi chala chinna vishayam, but ikkada list chustane number of awards vachi unnai already. So etuvanti awards tho mimmalni satkarincharu, etuvanti rewards vachayi?
The first one was, it's again an unforgettable one that we got, and it was something special. We got the first place in violin competition, and all over the country, where we came first, and we were awarded the gold medal by the Kanchi Kamakoti Math, which is very, very special for us, made an auspicious beginning in our career.
Okay.
After that, we have been, I mean,
plenty of awards.
Yes, plenty of.
In fact, we were the youngest female violinist to be awarded the Kalai Mamani, which is the highest state government award from the government of Tamil Nadu.
Okay.
So for excellence in violin playing, for the contribution towards music. So that was again an unforgettable award, that recognition that we got from the state government.
Okay. And as a composers ga kuda unnaru meeru, so composers ga even a cinema lak chesara lekapothe pratyekanga emanna specialized composition emanna ichara?
We have actually our compositions, as we said, we do a lot of fusion music, and we studied the world music and fusion in the US and the UK, where we also had the opportunity to work on composition writing in fusion music.
Okay.
So mostly our the transglobal fusion concerts that we do, we compose our own compositions in our global.
We use idioms, I mean, from different genres of music to create a composition. So that is something which we do for fusion music. We have also composed music for some films and documentaries, and also plays, theater
and dance ballets as well.
Okay. అండ్ ఎటువంటి గోల్స్తో ముందుకు వెళ్తున్నారు? సో ప్రపంచవ్యాప్తంగా కూడా మీరు పెర్ఫార్మెన్సెస్ ఇచ్చారు, ఎన్నో అవార్డ్స్ రివార్డ్స్ మీ దారిలో వస్తూ ఉన్నాయి, అండ్ ఎటువంటి మెసేజ్ ప్రపంచానికి ఇస్తూ ఉన్నారు, ఎటువంటి గోల్స్ తోటి ముందుకు వెళ్తూ ఉన్నారు?
ఆర్ గోల్ ఇస్ టు టేక్ కర్ణాటిక్ మ్యూజిక్ వేర్ ఎవర్, ఐ మీన్ టు ద నుక్ అండ్ కార్నర్స్ ఆఫ్ ద వరల్డ్. ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ ఈవెన్ లాస్ట్ ఇయర్ వీ వర్ ఆన్ అ టూర్ ఆఫ్ యూరప్, వీ వెంట్ టు ప్లేసెస్ లైక్ వేర్ దే ఆర్ హియరింగ్ ద సౌత్ ఇండియన్ మ్యూజిక్ ఫర్ ద ఫస్ట్ టైమ్. వీ అన్ అన్ఫర్గెటబుల్ కాన్సర్ట్ వాస్ అట్ ద ఫారెస్ట్ ఇన్ Stockholm in Sweden. Okay. And they were so they thought Indian music, they most of them have heard about North Indian music. Mm-hmm. So they know after when we perform, they said, oh, your music is so beautiful. So then we told them, yes, India is so beautiful that it has two rich classical traditions, mm-hmm. one from the north and one from the south, yeah. which is the Carnatic music. So we've been taking Carnatic music to places where yet to be popularized, and we are so glad that we are able to take Carnatic music to all the nook and parts of the globe, yeah. and also to spread among the students that music is very, very important, and we only wish that every family, every child learns some bit of classical music, okay. Which will definitely refine a person, and it is helpful for the soul as well.
Okay. And maakosam chivarga oka annamacharya kirtane edaina maakosam play cheyandi. చాలా బాగుంది లలిత గారు అండ్ నందిని గారు, మీరు మా స్టూడియోకి రావడం మనస్ఫూర్తిగా కోరుకుంటున్నాం. మీ గోల్స్ అన్నీ రీచ్ అవ్వాలి, తర్వాత ప్రపంచవ్యాప్తంగా కూడా మ్యూజిక్లో మీరు గొప్ప మార్గదర్శకులుగా నిలవాలని చెప్పి కోరుకుంటూ ఉన్నాం భారత్ టుడే తరఫున. థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ అండి. ఇది నాటి కళాక్షేత్రం, చూస్తూనే ఉండండి భారత్ టుడే, భారతీయుల హృదయ స్పందన.